Hello and welcome back. I'm Gayatri from Kalnari Nirvana and today I'm going to show you how to make black bean and pasta soup recipe. For this recipe, I'm using onions, some delicious herbs, spices and vegetables like capsicum because that's the only thing I have on my hand. But you can use carrots, celery, even parsnip. And this is almost like a minestrone soup, but it's got my twist on it. So let's get started. Right, so for this recipe, I am using one medium onion, which I have small diced, few cloves of garlic, chili and rosemary. Don't worry about the ingredients, you can find all these ingredients step by step on my website. Then I'm going to use one can of black beans which I have washed thoroughly and then drained and put them in this bowl. 150 grams of pasta, you can use whichever pasta you have. I like to use fusilli because it's got that less doughiness to it. It's got a better texture. Then one can of diced tomatoes, this is about 1.5 cup. I'm using red capsicum which is small diced, and I'm also using 1 cup of green peas just to give that burst of color and a little bit more texture to my pasta. For spices, I'm using pink peppercorns which I will explain later, and black pepper powder, some salt. I'm going to cook this soup in olive oil, so this is completely vegan. And this is my vegetable stock paste. You can use one vegetable stock cube and add 1/2 cup of water in there. Right, so let's get started. My pan is hot. I am going to add some olive oil in there. So then I'm going to add my onions and garlic. Just going to give it a mix and cook this till the onion is nice and translucent for just maybe 2 to 3 minutes. Right, it has been about 2-3 minutes. Now I'm going to add my chilies. This is completely optional. You can use dry red chili flakes, but I like to use a little bit of red chili patties because it gives that really delicious spiciness, that kick to it. And also chilies are really good for you. They have anti-cancerous properties and they are antiviral, so why not? I feel that everything with chili makes it delicious. So after mixing the chilies, I'm going to add my rosemary into it. After adding the rosemary, I'm just going to give it a stir. And then I'm going to add my tomatoes. The reason I'm using canned tomatoes because it gives a really delicious tanginess to the soup and also this vibrant red color, which most of the times the fresh tomatoes will not give. And also canned tomatoes, I reckon it gives a little bit of body to your soup. So now I'm going to cook this on medium high for about 5 minutes. I forgot to mention one thing. After adding the tomatoes, add 1/2 teaspoon of salt in there. So adding the salt to your tomatoes and onions is going to cook it faster. Right, so it has been 5 minutes and my tomatoes are properly cooked. Now I'm going to add the vegetable stock paste in there. You can use vegetable stock as well instead of using water, but I find this much better. After adding the vegetable stock paste, I'm going to add my spices. So all I'm going to do, I'm just going to take 1/2 teaspoon of these pink peppercorns. I'm just going to kind of crush them in my palm. So, you know, all these beautiful essential oils are activated. Smells really good. I'm just going to add that in there. If you can't find these, it's fine. You can just use normal black peppercorns, but I would definitely recommend finding them. Then I'm going to add a little bit of black pepper. That's to your taste, but I like to add about 1/2 teaspoon because I like everything peppery, and especially in those winter days, or you know, right now it's quite rainy season in Singapore, so it kind of gives you really comforting feeling when you're having that bowl of soup. So after adding all of those, I'm just going to give it a mix, and I'm going to use the same cup I used for my tomatoes. I'm just going to weigh some water. I'm gonna add 750 milliliters of water in there. Go. After adding the water, I'm just going to put the pasta. Give it a stir. And then I'm going to add my black beans as well. After adding the black beans and pasta, I'm going to cover this pot slightly ajar and I'm going to cook this for 5 to 7 minutes. The reason I'm cooking it for 5 to 7 minutes because I don't want to cook the pasta completely because I'm going to add the capsicum and the green peas a little bit later. So I want that pasta to be slightly undercooked so that it gets cooked with all the vegetables. I like to just kind of give it a stir in between, otherwise pasta tends to stick to the bottom. So make sure that you're giving a stir in between that those 5-7 minutes. So this is about halfway done. And keep the gas on medium high, not on a very low flame, not on a very high flame, just somewhere in between. Alright, lovely people, so it has been about 5-7 minutes and ooh, look at that steam. And my pasta is about 80% done. And that's what exactly I want. Before I go ahead, I'm going to give it a taste because I like to taste my food before I add some more salt or any other seasonings I might need to add. It is perfect. However, I would like to cut down the acidity of the tomatoes. So I'm going to add half a teaspoon of brown sugar in there. That not only balances the tomato flavors but also cuts down the acidity. Completely optional. If you don't want, you don't have to add. You can also add maple syrup into it. You can also add coconut sugar. I'm just using brown sugar. And now I'm going to add my capsicum in there. The reason I didn't add the capsicum in the beginning because I like that crunch in the capsicum. It also gives that slight sweetness to it when it's not completely cooked. So I like to give one tip. A lot of times I see people, they kind of take defrosted beans and they just add it into their food. I like to wash my green peas, the frozen green peas, and then I like to add it to my food because I feel that, you know, the frozen ice kind of has a very strange smell sometimes. I like to kind of wash that off. So I'm going to add that in there. Give it a nice mix. And cook this soup for next 2-3 minutes. Alright, so it has been about 3-4 minutes and look at that. My soup is perfectly cooked, my pasta is perfectly cooked and it looks absolutely delicious. I'm going to serve this soup with miso and black garlic bread, which is a delicious spin on the traditional garlic bread, and the recipe will be up on my IGTV video, so don't forget to check that out. Hello. And if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel, and all the information about my website, my social media is in the description box below, so don't forget to check that out as well. So thanks for watching and see you again. Have a good day. Bye bye.